So friends, first one we completed and the second one also completed. If you look at the third one, basic principles of audit. Basic principles of audit. Look at here. First, take down all the notes which are shown in here, because it can be give clarity further. Pause the video and note down the notes. Basic principles of audit. What are the principles which govern the audit? The fundamental principle which govern the audit, which takes the audit procedure further. That means auditor should have integrity, objectivity and independence. Integrity means straightforward, and objectivity means must have the objectives on the audit. What is going to be found in that audit? He need to have one objective. Independence means should not be dependent on the management. He should give his opinion independently. And confidentiality, should not disclose the matter to the others. Skills and competence with respect to subject skills, communication skills and management skills. And the work performed by others. In the auditing, auditor has to verify the work performed by the branch auditor, that is relating to SA600, and the internal auditor SA610, and work performed by expert also he need to verify SA620. These essays are governing these matters. And the documentation. After the verification and examination of all the records, he should give report on all matter with respect to auditing. That is audit working papers, what are his findings and audit notebook, what is audit planning, audit program, and in this audit notebook and working papers, he need to have some matters prescribed by the law and other statutes. And previous audit reports should also form part of documentation. And planning. SA 300 governing this planning. What is audit planning? Is detailed discussed in SA 300. Audit planning means what is going to be done. What is going to be done should be framed in separate one sheet is called a planning. That is means a future course of action, what is to be done. And next, audit evidence. He should obtain all evidences with respect to his suspicious or doubt, and he can get clarity from the management. That is what audit evidence is. Accounting system and internal, how internal system is, internal control system is there in the enterprise, and how accounting system is working on, what are the risk with respect to internal system and accounting system. Risk of material misstatements, that is verification of all books of accounts with respect to financial statements framing. And after completion of all of this, he should conclude the audit and give audit report. Report means giving of his opinion based on all these matters. Okay. These are the basic principles which govern the auditing. These are the basic principles which govern the auditing. So next, if we look at the fourth one, that is qualities of audit. Next one is qualities of auditor. Auditor should be, it's the same like as basic principles of auditing, but what individual auditor should possess the qualities to be an auditor. Independence. Auditor should be independent of his opinion. That means free from all forces by the management and any interest given by the management. He should give his independent opinion. Next, integrity. Integrity, auditor should be a straightforward and honest and sincere in his work. When audit auditing is going on, he should be a straightforward in asking questions and taking explanation from the management. He should have that integrity. And objectivity, fair and unbiased approach, should not be a biased approach, because in auditing, if we have biased approach, there is a scope for fraud in the audit. It will reflect the management and the company like anything. It may be going for winding off. So confidentiality, next one. Confidentiality means should not disclose the client information to others. He should maintain that confidentiality. Professional competence and due care. He should update his knowledge, subject knowledge, as time to time. That means awareness of recent developments. Next, professional skepticism. This is an important term which we need to use in auditing. Professional skepticism means questioning with a common sense. Auditor should ask the question to the management with a common sense, because where auditor need to have a clear cut idea about what need to be done and what he wants to from the management, then only he can go further in the audit. Depends on the personal judgment regarding the audit risk and procedure to obtain audit evidences and materiality, where material items are disclosed or not. Procedure, when obtaining audit evidences, he should follow some rules and regulations with respect to audit evidences. He can get clarity from the management like anything. And audit risk, internal, there may be three risks associated with the audit: inherent risk and detection risk and concurrent risk. There are three audit risks. He need to ask the questions with a common sense. That's what we call it as professional skepticism. This is an important term which we need to use in auditing regularly. So these are the qualities of an auditor. We can expect from both of these at least one mark. From both of these basic principles of an auditing and qualities of an auditor, we can expect one question from this. Next part is to qualities of an auditor is completed. Next, types of audit. I am giving a glance of chart. Please take down first this. This is an all classification of audit based on some basis. Okay. Types of audit. First, based on legislative control and organizational structure. Please go through this carefully. Definitely we can get one mark from out of this. I am giving a glance idea about what types of audit will be there in auditing. This independently you can study what with respect to individual audit. So first, organizational structure. Based on organizational structure, audit is divided into statutory audit, government audit, private audit, and individuals and NPOs audit. NPOs means non-profit organizations audit. With respect to non-profit organizations and individuals, audit is compulsory. As per auditing standard, audit is compulsory with respect to individuals and NPOs. Statutory audit, which is required to be take audit as per statute governed by those organizations, either respective statute or the company law. As per as now, Companies Act 2013 will be there. As per Companies Act 2013 only, statutory auditor will be appointed. And next, government audit. For government audit, government organization, they need to follow COG Act, that is COG, Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Comptroller and Auditor General. This act came into force from 1971. We can expect one question from this: who is present COG? Present cog is Shashkant Sharma. Okay. With respect to organization structure, these are the audits. That with respect to relation, external audit means done by an outside auditor. This is done yearly once. Next, internal audit. It may be done by employer and appointed person. There is no qualification with respect to internal audit, but external audit should be done by a qualified chartered accountant. Next, periodicity. Based on classification, based on periodicity. Periodicity, first audit is based on periodicity, first audit, continuous audit, next concurrent audit, interim audit, periodical audit, occasional audit, annual audit, that means final audit, next balance sheet audit. In this, balance sheet and final audit is our most important. Next, balance sheet audit means to know the authenticity of assets and liabilities. The company should engage the balance sheet audit. Generally in India, this will not be there. This is the recent development in auditing. And the next, annual audit. Every company should engage annual audit to know the financial results of a concern. Next, concurrent audit will be mainly done in banks. Interim audit means any audit which taken place between two AGMs called interim audit. This will give the results of interim period. Next, continuous audit means continuous audit is an audit which will be done throughout the year. Okay. Next, classification based on the scope or coverage. Complete audit, partial audit, detailed audit. Complete audit means from the starting origin to completion of the transaction. That's what we call it as complete audit. Partial audit means we can call it this as a test check. Next, detailed audit. Audit in depth means every transaction origin to completion auditor has to check. No company should engage this detailed audit because it incurs lots of expenses. Next, specific classification based on specific objectives. Independent financial audit, operational audit to know operational results, and cost audit. Very, very, very important with respect to company audit. In that, company audit section 148 of Companies Act 2013 dealing with cost audit. Section 148. Remember the section also. There may be a possibility of asking the question in the examination. Section 148 deals with cost audit. We will discuss the section 48 in detail in further classes. Next, the management audit. Next, internal audit. Next, tax audit, secretarial audit, social audit, and environmental audit. Based on specific objective, we can find internal audit here, and based on relation also, internal audit we can find. It come under both the ways, because for internal audit there may be a specific objectives to have internal control. For a relation, there may be internal, so internal users are there, external users are. Based on that only, we have classified the internal audit here. Based on specific objective, classified the internal audit here. And the manner of checking, this is the important term which we can expect. Vouch and post, checking of each and every, that means every transaction, entry from the origin to completed. In SAP, that means an application programming, if we enter one transaction, where the end of this transaction we need to find. That's what we call it as watch and post. From the ending to, we need to come back also, what is the origin of this transaction. That process we call it as watch and post. So this is with respect to classification classification of audit. So thank you, and we are going to upload further videos also. Thank you for watching.